AJ Terrell has been suspended for academic reasons. That's how we're gonna begin this video of NCAA Football 07. It's a sad story that we're gonna have to suspend all our players, but here we are starting this game against Boston College as we are on the road. And Boston College decides to receive as we're beginning this game. And here's the kickoff. And we're starting this game. Number 32 with the kickoff. And now let's see how they do, how they fare in the first drive of the game. So last time around, Clemson lost the game. And they did a lot of mistakes along the way. Let's see if they can correct those mistakes as they get a few yards on the play for a 2nd and 5. So let's see how Pope does in this drive. 2nd and 5 on the 31. Pope back to pass. And the pass will fall incomplete after he got hit. 3rd and 5 on the 31. Let's see if he can do something about this situation. Here's the handoff. No, it's a play action. Here's the pass and he is complete. Holloway. And he somehow finds a way to make that pass work in his favor. That could have been a little bit disastrous, but then again at the end of the day, that pass was a bit more complete. And he was a bit open overall. So now we're going on 1st and 10 on the opposing 32. After a nice pass from Pope. Pope calling adjustments. And here's a play action. And it's a complete to Washington. Oh, and he gets hit hard. Dang. That's got hurt in the morning, and that's going to be a 2nd and 1 on the 23. 4 plays, 51 yards, and 1 minute 6 seconds of possession so far for Boston College. Pope back to pass complete. And that's going to be a 1st down. A nice pass overall by Pope as he hit his target. 1st and 10 on the 12. Let's see if they can get a touchdown this time around. If they don't get a touchdown, they might be a bit disappointing. 10 seconds on the play clock. Here's a handoff and he's going to get hit hard. Oh my. But he's going to move forward 6 yards to get a 2nd and 4 on the 6 yard line. Clock is moving at 3:03. Pope back to pass. Here's the pass. And that pass will fall incomplete. That was just a bad play by the fullback. I think he was just not thinking straight right there. That should have been a complete pass. Maybe move forward a few yards. Here's a handoff. And Pope is going to get sacked. It's going to be a 4th down situation, 4th and 10. A nice play by the Clemson defense right there. They came up big. Bent, but didn't break. And now here's the kicking team to try to set up 3 points on the board. A 29-yarder. And the kick is up, and the kick is good. Right down the uprights. 9 plays, 62 yards, and 2 minutes and 22 seconds of time possession. Let's see if they can do something on defense as Clemson will receive the ball. Here's number 17 with the kickoff return, and he might just be inside the 20. 1st and 10 on the 21, and so far Clemson needs to work on a few things on offense. Last week, we saw a lot of interceptions from number 16, from Long. And he's going to get sacked big time, and he's going to lose a lot of yards. One of the big problems that Lawrence has is that he goes way back into the pocket, which means that they lose a lot of yards. If they want to recover big time, they got to eliminate those mistakes. If you got to get sacked, you got to get sacked. At the end of the day, you must make sure that at the very least, that sack ends up being a loss of 5 instead of a loss of 23 or a loss of 13. Lawrence back to pass. The pass to Rodgers is complete. And it seems to be a mediocre start for Lawrence. As we will see what happens on the field. Lawrence, the handoff to Etienne, and he's going to get hit hard. He's going to lose yards, and that's going to be a fourth down. And they will be forced to go three and out. Number 48 going down the punt. Number 48 goes on and has to punt. And the punt will go to number 27, and he gets hit hard. Man, that's gotta hurt in the morning. Let's look at that replay once again. He was just hunting him down that time. No mercy. First and 10 on the 40, as they will try to get a touchdown this time around. The last time they were on the field, they got a field goal and got 3 points on the board. Pope back to pass. The pass will be incomplete as he goes out of bounds. Second and 10 on the 40. Let's see if they can get something going on. Pope, handoff. And that one will move on maybe a yard or two. Maybe three. Third and 7 on the 43. Let's see what he can do here. Pope goes back to pass. The pass will be complete to Shaq. And he gets a few yards for the first down. First and 10 on the opposing 41. Pope 5 for 8, 78 yards on the day. He's had a good start, but he really needs to get a touchdown this time around. And he's going to go back and lose a few yards. Maybe not. He's going to stay where they were. Second and 10. On the 41, Pope making adjustments. Pope back to pass. Here's a pass to number 30. Yes, he will move up maybe a few yards on the play at most. Third and 8 and 8. 5 plays, 21 yards, and 1:06 of possession. Pope goes back to pass. And that one, he will launch it. And that ball, sorry, that pass would be deflected, incomplete, and now they will go on a 4th and 8. Let's see what they will do, and they will go for it. They are confident that they can get a few points on the board. Let's see what they do. Pope goes back to pass. The pass right into the turf, incomplete. And that's a 1st and 10 on the 39. 15 seconds to go in the first quarter. Gonna check the play here. And he's gonna get sacked. Walking right straight to the sack. That's just not good blocking right there. You could blame that in part to the quarterback, but at the same time, the blocking really gotta be there. That's the end of the first quarter. Boston College leading Clemson 3-0. And we will go to second quarter. 2nd and 12 on the 37. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the pass, and it will be deflected, incomplete. Setting a 3rd and long here on the 37. They don't want to go back 3 and out again. They want to get a big play here. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the pass, and right into the turf, incomplete. And they will have to go 3 and out again. Number 48 with the punt. They do that, but it's not going to work for much. Maybe a few yards on the return. 1st and 10 on the 29. Last time around, they lost possession of the ball via turnover on downs. 1st and 10 on 1st and 10, and that pass will be deflected, complete to Holloway, and he's doing amazing things today. 2nd and 5 on the 34 after an amazing catch by Holloway. Wasting some time here. Trying to get things sorted out. Here's the handoff, and he will get tackled forward for a 1st down. 1st and 10 on the 40. Let's see what they can do here. Here's a handoff to number 30. He will move up nowhere. He will stay where he is. Second and 10 on the 40. Three plays, 11 yards, and 1 minute and 4 seconds of possession. This has been a really productive defensive possession for Clemson. And they're going to hope to continue that in this play. Right into the turf, incomplete. Holloway might have been the intended receiver on that play, 3rd and 10. Let's see if they can get a first down here. Cope goes back to pass. And he will get tackled, but not before throwing the ball incomplete. And now they will go 3 and out themselves. Number 46, going to punt. And the ball will go to number 3. And he will get hammered to the 30. And we will see a 1st and 10 on the 30-yard line. Let's see if they can get something going. Last two drives, 3 and out. They really want to be different this time around. A handoff to ATN for maybe a modest gain of 2. Not so modest after all, so I don't know. 2nd and 8 on the 32. They really want to get back into a swing of things here. Lawrence back to pass. The pass to ATN for a completion, and they get a first down. And that's their first down of the game. It took them a quarter and 2 minutes to do so, but they finally get something going. 1st and 10 on the 45. And up to ATN for maybe a yard or 2 on the play. Maybe 3, I don't know. For a 2nd and 7 on the 48. The clock is ticking. Let's see what they do here. Here's the handoff, and the quarterback's keeping it. And he's going to go straight towards a first down. Not the best run in the world, but he gets a first down, and that's what matters. 1st and 10 on the opposing 45. Lawrence back to pass. Here's the pass to Rodgers, and that might be a 2nd and short. 2nd and 1 play at the 36. So they really haven't had much success on the ground, but passing the ball, they really done fine, all right. Or maybe depending on how you look at it. 2nd and 1, Lawrence back to pass. And that pass will fall incomplete, 3rd and 1. And now the crowd's chanting defense. You really know they want that stop. Lawrence a handoff to ATN, and this is going to be a 4th down. Let's see if they decide to go for it, and they do. 4th and inches. Here's the handoff to ATN, and he will get a 1st down. Didn't need that much, and he took advantage of the situation. 1st and 10 on the 32. They really need to capitalize in this situation. Lawrence, the handoff to Renfro. And he will get 3 yards on the run. For 2nd and 7 on the 29. 9 plays, 41 yards on 2 minutes of possession so far for Clemson. Lawrence goes back to pass. Trying to go big back. Complete to Rodgers. And they are inside the red zone. 1st and 10 on the 15. Let's see what they do here. Rodgers, 3 catches, 41 yards. He's really looking to make a name of himself in this game. Lawrence back to pass. The pass, it is intercepted, and Barrett barrels through a defender or through a tackler, and he's going to go back to the 25. And Boston College finds a way to get things done with an interception inside the red zone. Not the best pass in the world. In fact, I would look for other options. Instead, they give up the possession, intercepted, and they get nothing out of this drive. A shame. 1st and 10 on the 25. 4-for-8 for Lawrence in this game. So the interception bug might be hitting him again in this game. Pope Mack the passer, pass to Shaq, and then he gets the first down, getting to the 38. Shaq so far 40 yards, 17 of them after the catch. He seems to be doing all right. Pope back the pass, and it is picked off. And Clemson gets the ball back at the 45. Number 57 responsible for the interception. For an interception. I can't talk to you, I don't know. Nice catch on his part. And now Clemson will get back onto the field after allowing an interception last time around. Let's see what they can do here. Will they have enough time? And no, it's a play action. Rodgers, oh, right to the turf, incomplete. That pass looked pretty good to me. Lack of execution on the receiver's end. Second and 10 on the 45. Lawrence back to pass. The pass to Thompson, complete. And it will be a 3rd and 3 on the 38 as Clemson calls a timeout. They really need to get something going here, otherwise they'll be going to a locker room trailing by a field goal. And he will get sacked on midfield. Not what you wanna have, oh no. Let's look at this play once again. That's just, I don't care who you are, that has to hurt. 4th and 15, fourth to go, 3 and out. Number 48 with the punt. Mayfield getting almost nothing on that return. 1st and 10 on the 17. Hand off. Number 30. And he will get a 2nd and 1 here. He's moving the ball all right in this game. At the end of the first half, Boston College leading Clemson 3-0. A really defensive matchup here. As we're starting the second half with a Clemson reception, or Clemson return, I don't know. And they will go right now and start a drive at the beginning of the second half. So Clemson needs to find a way to avoid the turnover at all costs. ATN on the run. And he will get a few yards from the play, sending him on a 2nd and 4. Second and fourth on a 33-yard line. And off goes to ATN for a first down. First and 10 on the 39, they're looking to get something out of this drive. Lawrence back to pass, and he will get sacked again. This O-line is just deteriorating right before our very eyes. Second and long here. Let's look at this replay again. That O-line needs to get fired ASAP. You just can't do that to your quarterback. Second and long here on the 29. The work undone by the O-line. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the pass to Richard. And they move forward to the 43. 3rd and 6. 3rd and 6 on the 43. Let's see what they do here. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's a pass. And it is intercepted again. And they just gotta stop with these interceptions. Look for better options down the field. They just can't afford to do this anymore. They can't be relying on the defense all game long to get this up to themselves. A really bad pass right there. I mean, that's just terrible passing. There's no question about it. And now it will be a 1st and 10 on the 42. Looking to capitalize on this situation. Pope goes back to pass. The pass is complete to Washington. And he was wide open on that pass, no doubt about it. So gonna replay once again. Monster defender, and he got a few yards right there. First and 10 on the 32. Let's see what they do here. Pope goes back to pass. The pass complete. And they will move forward a few yards. Second and 6. Second and 6 on the 28. Clemson trying to make a stop here. Pope the handoff to number 30, and he's not going to go anywhere but back. Setting up a 3rd and 7 on the 29. 2 for 5 on 3rd down conversions for Boston College. Let's see if they can do something right now. Pope goes back to pass. Here's the pass, and it is complete to Washington as they enter the red zone. A nice play right there by them. Now send them for 1st and 10 on the 13. Pope with a handoff. No, it's a play action. And that one will be out of bounds. Didn't get to step in. And that will be a 2nd and 10 on the 13. Pope goes back to pass. And he will get sacked by number 6. Nice play on his part. Let's look at that replay once again. That was a nice job of him going straight to the quarterback. Bryant is responsible for the sack. 3 for 6 on 3rd down conversions for Boston College. They will be looking to add another completion here and get a 1st down. Pope back to pass. And he will get sacked again. And the O-line for Boston College is also deteriorating right before their very eyes. And here we go, the field goal unit to try to get some points on the board. Number 37. A 40-yard field goal attempt. The kick is up and the kick is good. 8 plays, 35 yards on 2 minutes and 43 seconds of possession. And here we are with a kickoff. ATN back to receive. Back to return, I mean. I just don't know. I know it's return, but I keep on saying stuff. I don't know. I can't talk. 1st and 10 on the 26 for Clemson, as they will be looking to take the lead here with a touchdown. We need to avoid the turnovers at all costs. Lawrence goes back to pass, avoids the sack, but the ball goes right into the turf, incomplete. And the passing woes continue for Lawrence. 2nd and 10 on the 26. And he might be calling adjustment here. Lawrence, the handoff to ATN, running right to the O-line and the D-line, and he gets hurt on the play. Not what you want to see out of a player like that. That just hurts. They lose a really important piece of the puzzle. 3rd and 14 on the 22. They've been 0 for 5 on 3rd down conversions tonight. They really need to find a way to get that 1st down. And here's a pass to Renfro, and that's gonna be a 4th down. Will they go for it or will they punt it? Let's see what happens. And they will go for it on 4th and 4. They want to be aggressive here. They can't afford to make any mistakes. So they're going for it. Lawrence goes back to pass. The pass to Richard, complete for a 1st down. 1st and 10 on the 39. Travis Etienne out for the game with a bruised shoulder. They will miss him. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the pass to Rodgers, complete, but it will still not be a first down. Lawrence with three straight completions as we end the third quarter. Boston College 6, Clemson nothing on second and 2 on the 47. They're going to look to get a first down here. Lawrence goes back to pass. The pass complete and he fumbles. The worst possible time to fumble as Boston College recovers. And those turnovers, they are either interceptions or fumbles. They got to stop at it. But number 27 is celebrating ridiculously. This might end up in a penalty, and yes, it does. A flag on the play. Unsportsmanlike conduct most likely. Send them back a few yards. And that's going to hurt big time. First and 25 for Boston College. And so far, Boston College has been the more dominant offensive team. But they haven't really scored much. Only 6 points up to this point. It's still anybody's game. Send them up backwards. Or no, maybe a bit forward for 2 yards. I don't know. Second and long here on the 30. Looking to correct their mistakes. Pope goes back to pass. And the pass will be tipped incomplete. Send up for a third and very long. 3-for-7 on third down conversions for the Boston College Eagles. Pope goes back to pass. The pass complete, but it will be a fourth down. They will be forced to go 3 and out. Number 46 going back to punt. Number 46 with the punt. Number 3 going back to return the punt. And he will only get a few yards on that return. First and 10 on the 38. Looking to get something going after the last horrible drive, getting a fumble. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the pass, and it is tipped incomplete by the defensive back. Not the right time to make mistakes like those. They really need to find a way to get a touchdown here. They can still win this game, but they're just losing it. Lawrence with a play action. Complete, but he will only go backwards. Or maybe not, I don't know. 3rd and 8 on the 40. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the pass complete to Thompson. And they move forward. Let's see if they can capitalize on this. We still have a shot at winning this game. Let's see if they can score. Lawrence back to pass. The pass complete to Renfro. And he will go forward a few yards, setting him up for a 2nd and 4. Lawrence with 3 straight completions. Let's see if he can keep up the momentum. They really have been struggling on the run in this game. 2nd and 4. Lawrence goes back to pass complete. Oh no, he fumbles again. The worst moment for this. Why do they keep on fumbling? This needs to stop right now. 1st and 10 on the 22. 3 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Lawrence 14 for 22. Trying his best. Pope goes back to pass. The completion to Holloway. Short of the first down marker, maybe a 2nd and 1 on the, I don't know, can't talk today. 2nd and 1 on the 31, Holloway 3 receptions, 51 yards. You gotta look to get a first down here. Trying to look to waste some time here. Pope with the handoff knows the play action and is tipped incomplete. Nice job defending that pass. 3-for-8 on third down conversions for Boston College. Let's see what they do here. Here's the handoff. No, it's a play action. Complete the Holloway. Wide open for that catch. 4 receptions, 63 yards for Holloway. They really need to find a way to stop him. 7 yards after the catch for Holloway. First and 10 on the 43. Trying to look for a score here. Hope goes back to pass. Here's the pass and it will be incomplete. Number 38, don't celebrate because you might get a penalty. But anyways, second and 10 on the 43. 4 plays, 21 yards on 1 minute and 9 seconds of the drive. And he gets hit hard, my goodness. But moving forward 2 yards from the play, 3rd and 8. Third and 8 on the 45. 4-for-9 on third down conversions. Pope, a pass to Cox for a completion. Or it will be a 4th and inches situation. It looked like a first down to me, but hey, I'm not the referee. 4th and inches going 3 and out. And they could have gone for it. Trying to waste some time here. And here's the punt. And he calls for a fair catch. Uh-oh, he muffed it. Oh, no. But there's a flag on the play. Let's see what the flag is. And it's going to be kick catch interference. So send him up for a first and 10 on the 21. Lawrence goes back to pass. The pass to Williams complete for only a yard. And they will go no huddle. They have no time to waste. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the pass to Rogers for a first down. And they are still going no huddle here. First and 10 on the 42. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the catch. Complete. And he will go no huddle again. What will they do this time around? I'm gonna have to spike it. And he spikes it. Second and 10 on the 38 after the spike. Goes back to pass and he gets sacked. Where the hell is the O-line? They're not protecting the quarterback well. Timeout called for Clemson. Third and 22 on the 50. Lawrence goes back to pass. Getting hit hard and Appam will fall incomplete after getting hit hard, but there's a flag on the play. Let's see what it is. And it might be illegal touching. Why does that penalty exist? I don't know. Fourth and long on the 50. They really have to go for it here. 20 seconds to go. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's the pass, complete to Thompson. And they will call a timeout. They can still win this game with a big play. First and 10 on the 25. 14 seconds left. Lawrence goes back to pass. And the ball will be tipped incomplete with 10 seconds left in this game. Not the time to be allowing these things to happen. Lawrence goes back to pass. Here's a pass incomplete. How the hell do you not catch that ball? 6 seconds to go. Maybe it's the last play of the game. Lawrence goes back to pass. Lawrence complete to Thompson, but they cannot get a touchdown and it's over. Boston College beats Clemson 6-0. If the question is, did the Eagles win or did the Tigers lose it? The Tigers lost it via turnovers. So that's it for this game. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon for more videos like this one. This was a sad game overall for Clemson. They could have won, but their own turnovers hurt them. At the end of the day, they only beat themselves. And they're gonna have to find a way to fix that. This team needs to become more mature. So yeah, anyways, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with another video. Peace.